Welcome to the Smoke Learning Channel. I am your host, Grant Kay. Throughout this video series, we will be dealing with the technical challenge of alpha channels. For those of you who do not know about alpha, this is a great primer to get you started. And for more experienced users, this series will show you all the workflows involving alpha channels and how to use them correctly within Autodesk Smoke. Let's get started. A typical video image normally consists of color channels. The red, green, and blue channels are added together to form the final colors in our image. This is expected of all image and movie formats. So what has this all got to do with the alpha channel? In one simple word, transparency. Unlike the red, green, and blue channels that are designed to store color, certain image and movie formats can also store another channel that is dedicated to transparency. The alpha channel controls the transparency or opacity for the red, green, and blue color channels. By defining black, gray, and white values in the alpha channel, you can cut out certain portions of your image. This is the mechanism behind compositing images together. For example, if you had to composite a CGI character over a live-action background, the CGI files would be rendered with an alpha channel to very easily cut them out and composite them over the background. Image files such as TARGAs, TIFFs, PNG, and OpenEXR, as well as movie file formats such as Animation QuickTime and Apple ProRes, are a few of the formats that can support the alpha channel alongside the RGB color channel. The final important part of alpha channels is to be aware that there are two types, the straight alpha and the pre-multiplied alpha. Further on in the series, there will be a video dedicated to the differences and how they affect your compositing in Autodesk Smoke. You might also hear me refer to alpha as a mat or cutout. This is because over time, the alpha channel has been known by these names because of how they were created for traditional film and video formats. That's just a bit of extra knowledge for you to digest. So why do a series on alpha channels in Autodesk Smoke if alpha channels are common practice these days? Well, unlike most applications, Smoke breaks the alpha channel out into a separate clip to make it more versatile. That does affect the way you approach tasks throughout all areas of Smoke. So to ensure you don't miss a thing, we are going to start at the very beginning dealing with importing, going all the way through editing, timeline compositing, node-based compositing, and ultimately exporting out with an alpha channel. Please continue to the next video on how to import files with an alpha channel. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Smoke Learning Channel for future videos.